Hi, this is Max 8 synthesizer development, and this is my first synthesizer I've started to make. You see it's in the left volume. Let me get a new. Wave out, to B, we'll call it, save. So we'll start recording the audio. And then I have these two, cycle tilde is sine wave, is a sine wave, is a cycle sine wave like that. And we're seeing the sine wave here, but we really aren't seeing it because it's just in one direction, and I'm using both directions. When they are matched up, the frequencies being 483, they make a nice pattern, sort of, kind of. Something's too loud. Something's too loud. Let's just lower the temperature, the volume of that. Be cycling like that. Let's change the cycle. These are nice patterns. It's two sine waves. And they is 1 point away from each other. 1 point, one hertz, cycles hertz. We go down to 83. There, you get this sine wave. And that's a neat one. And we can change the shape of the two of them. You see, the one is going in on the left side, one's going in on the right side. This is the left side up and down values of the amplitude. This is the right up and down. So when you mix them together, it turns into a circle, usually with this distance from the center being the volume. So straighten out the circle, maybe bring that down some, up some, up some. Now I have these two triangle waves here, tri tilde, and they're going to add something to it. And I went with the left one first, so it's adding a triangle to that. That's pretty neat. And this one is the right, and it's off a different frequency, so you get kind of chaos, two sines, two triangles. And then on the end, I have two saws. Now they seem to all be at different values. I'll make that even more different. That's 2 plus 2. You can hear it change. The sign. I'm going to jump right in with a saw. Saw at 469 hertz. Cycles per second. Another saw on the other side. Now, what does it look like with two triangles? Let's just see that. Now, these are just two triangles. They are at different frequencies. We're going to bring this down to 457, if we can, the right side. And it does change shape. You see, now it's closer, it's closer. These are interesting shapes, really. Oh, we're 1 point away from each other. This is 57 and 458. And then, well, 457, 461. Very hard to get minuscule. Well, I can go decimal. Four fifty-seven point two. So those are the two triangles, left and right, and it's quite neat. So, we got that, and that's a neat thing. And then we're gonna introduce the two. Let me try to get this down to just 57. There. That's 57, and it looks like that. I think that it looks like that because of these volume levels. Change the volume level. I actually liked it better with them off from each other. I'm going to bring this up 3, and this maybe down. No, I didn't. It's just up 0.4. The one on the left is 0.4 high, and it just interferes with each other. It's like an interference, and it is louder too. Bring that down. And let's see what a synchronized sine wave added. That's the sine wave to the right. And the sine wave, exact sine wave to the left. I should have tried it. I think it's a delayed, a lag going on, because it's just not there. There we are. What's it doing? That? No. Yeah, you see it sets up a pattern. Bring that out. Add a phaser, add a rectangle, and the two saws that are out of sync. There, I matched the saws, so I'm gonna drop everything down. Saws, and these are saws. That's a neat pattern for exactly matching saws left and right. Yeah, that's real wild pattern of a saw. And we'll just throw the sign in on the right. Take effect at a sign, it just bounces it out. And we'll do that with both of them. And they're at different levels, the sign and the saw. So I could match their frequencies, but that would be overtime and overkill and beyond the 10-minute mark. I'm gonna stop at 10.